No, thank you very much, thank you.
Good evening, Madam Chairman. It's been a very instructive evening for me sitting there. I've never addressed a planning committee in favour of an application before. I have to tell you a story. When this application was passed in the first place, Mike Freer, the then leader, said Richard, get this done, as I was a newly shiny-assed regeneration cabinet member. I'm afraid this has effectively been in a deep and dusty drawer for a long time. And this is something that is very regrettable to us as the guardians of the local economy. It is also something that increases tension for the local residents and those who would come and live here. It is very important that this is put to bed and we get on with this application. And I believe that this amendment to the scheme, because there is a scheme that already has planning permission, and this is an amendment being considered tonight, is something that should go ahead. I'm particularly pleased that the last speaker alluded to the search for tenants for the new stores in the expanded Brent Cross. Of course, I mean, perhaps it's unfair to give a lesson in economics. It won't go ahead unless the developers do believe that there are people who will come and occupy the stores. Similarly, customers will get here and they will come here. The parking is being maintained at its current level. The new bus lanes and the new bus garage will be a much more attractive venue than the existing. There is also the realignment of the road network and the upgrade in the access from the tube, which will all be very important. I think this is something that is really very exciting. I don't often get all beady-eyed and enthusiastic, but I mean, just grasp the vision, if you like, of a marvellous new shopping centre. Brent Cross, when it was first built, was the best in Britain, and I believe it can be again. Yeah. I think it is something that we should all be enthused about. The new housing on the other side of the North Circular and development there will actually cheer up our whole area. This is a very positive thing, and the council will have to maintain high building standards and high standards of design as the details come forward.
Thank you. Obviously, retail shopping has played, but also there's more competition in the big crop of Westfield. Stratford, if you can look at what continues at the West End, all based on public transport, on the fact that you can get there by public transport. One of the worries I have, and I would just like your opinion on it, is that we don't seem to have been enough to think in terms of, I know Ms. Major's talked about buses, but the things like the concept of a light railway or other orbital things that will actually expand, but also be more of a, make it more of a matter. Would you support any the idea of pursuing this idea of the light railway, or the orbital light railway?
I'm curious about the idea of a light railway, and I think it should be explored to see that it's possible. But from the point of view of consideration of this planning application, I believe that is something very, very aspirational and unlikely to be delivered in the near future.
Yes, Councillor Cornelius, you said you came to this meeting with your mind made up to support the application. And you sat and listened to, I think, 13 speakers with cogent arguments why they think this application should be rejected. Did any of their submissions have any impact on you at all?
You know that the notes that I've taken are in my customary handwriting, very spidery and difficult to read. But one of the first lady to speak mentioned the uncertainty about this development and the fact that it's caused stress for residents, and that's something that really struck home.
Thank you.
Oh, it's a shame.